We're moving on. Shocked locals are gathering to grieve the loss of TV chef Matt Golinski's family in a house fire tragedy.
Tegan George is at Taunton on the Sunshine Coast and she joins us now. Tegan, Matt Golinski was severely burned in this tragedy. What is his current condition?
Kath, we understand Matt's condition is very similar to what it was last night. He's being treated at the Royal Brisbane Hospital. He's in the intensive care unit there. He is listed as critical but stable. We understand he is heavily sedated and that he possibly underwent surgery today. So this tragedy has just devastated the community and they are praying and thinking of Matt and hoping he pulls through.
A crushed community coping the best they can.
It's just so hard to digest. You know, Matt was one of these people who was just extraordinary.
In Noosa, Matt Golinski isn't just a celebrity chef. Hard-working, talented and passionate, he's a real part of many people's lives.
You'd always ask him how the girls were and how his wife was and his face would just light up.
The 39-year-old is fighting for his life in the Royal Brisbane Hospital after his family's Taunton home was engulfed by fire yesterday morning. He suffered severe burns trying to save his wife Rachel and their three young daughters. Tragically, they didn't make it out.
She was beautiful. She never had a bad word to say about anybody. Smile for everybody.
In a message on Facebook, Matt's aunt says he's undergoing surgery today and is still heavily sedated. She says, "We are all numb, but so strengthened by the amount of love, care and warmth we are feeling from so many people." Matt's friends are devastated.
Oh, geez, I just hope the bugger, you know, pulls out of this and gets well, you know. I mean, just the outpouring that I have felt has been, it's palpable.
Such a wonderful, genuine, gentle individual. He really is. And in the food scene, you know, this has rocked everybody.
Friends say he lived for his girls, 12-year-old twins Sage and Willow and 10-year-old Stalia. A collection of toys and flowers now mark the front of the family's home as friends come to pay their respects. Offers of assistance and donations have also been rolling in to help keep Matt's catering company up and running. The house has been handed back to the family. The fire has been ruled non-suspicious, but police are investigating whether candles or Christmas lights could have sparked the blaze. Tegan George, 10 News.